文探秘。
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Wanton Mean here in Sham Shui Po in Hong Kong, this fantastic space where we're holding a series of tiny galaxy concerts under the Hong Kong Sinfonietta sort of chamber series, if you like. And tonight we've got one large work for you, a good, I suppose, 25 minutes or so. The duo for violin and cello by Zoltán Kodály, the great Hungarian composer, along with Bartók, the two major figures of the first half of the 20th century in Hungary. This is a really special, rather intense, incredibly difficult and draining work to play as a performer. And I want to ask Aurélien Pascal, who I'm very lucky to be sitting next to with, how you feel about playing this work, because you've of course played many times the solo sonata. There's a number of fantastic works by Kodály. There's a second string quartet, which I've also played, but I haven't had the privilege of playing the solo cello sonata, which is opus 8. The duo is opus 7. How do you feel about playing these works of Kodály?
I feel a lot related to this music because I myself grew up by listening to mainly Hungarian cellists like Janos Starker, and I had the incredible chance to work with him this duo with my brother when I got very young, and that will always stay like a strong memory of musical journey. And whenever I play this music, I feel really related to the core of music in it, folk, in the folk way. One can really see Kodály did all this research about the folk music, going into all the places in East Europe and collecting all the songs, and which is why I think it's really interesting work, and it will be timeless.
I was just thinking, actually, you talk about the local aspect of Kodály's research into folk music, and coming to a local place like this, it's far from the mountains of Hungary, but this is a very local mixed area of Hong Kong, Sham Shui Po area. So in a way, coming to a small place like this, it feels kind of an authentic place to play it.
It does make sense, It does make sense. It's supposed to be played, like, I think, in small places like this. And I think you will enjoy this work very much, as we put a lot of energy into.
It's a very rewarding and challenging work to play. It's in three quite large movements, and the finale, the last movement, has a long kind of rhapsody, like a slow introduction. So it's like a typical lasso frisse, slow start and a quick, kind of crazy dance-like finale, and the slow movement is very inward and introspective. You know, he was writing it at the beginning of the First World War, and there's maybe some of this internal struggle in this very sort of dark and austere movement. So it's a great work, and I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.